All right, good afternoon. Welcome to Keeping It Real with Pastor Mo. Today we got a question about the upcoming event of the Little Rock highlight of our year. We're talking about homecoming. How you doing, Pastor McCray?
I'm doing good, my brother.
So you my Pastor Mo,
yes, sir.
Reverend
yes,
Mo.
Sir.
Yeah, okay. All right. So Pastor Mo, we know we've been doing this for a couple of years. How many years have we been doing homecoming at LRBC?
Well, homecoming, actually, we've been doing it ever since I started. So this is my, going into my 8th year, so we've done it 7 times.
Wow, okay.
So this is the 7th annual, or one of those, 7th or 8th annual homecoming. And each year, it's kind of progressed and grown into something that has been a phenomenal day for us here at the Little Rock Church.
Gotcha. Rev, if you could, I kind of think I understand the rationale for it. But for the viewers who may not be familiar or people who are thinking about coming, can you tell us a little bit about why is or what is homecoming?
Sure. Well, before I started pastoring, I would always see churches have homecoming services. So I thought it would be cool to try to have it or to start it here. But the premise of it is really to highlight some of the preachers or some of the moments but the preachers are individuals who have left our ministry and God has planted them somewhere else and to kind of bring them back home. Who wouldn't want to preach at their home church? And on top of that, when we ask members of our church who have now become clergy and going on to ministry and pastor in other places, we also try to make it a big old family reunion. So we're trying to get all of our members who perhaps are not worshiping somewhere else or are connected to another ministry to come back so we can come together rather than us just seeing each other on homegoing services. Let's come back to homecoming services in a festive event. And it's kind of evolved from that. So then, about year three or four, we started it in, and we were noticing that it was in Black History Month. Mm-hmm. So in our context, we grew up here and there were some people in our church who are historic figures to us that grew up in the church and have done great things in the church. So
sure.
It was a great way also to give them their flowers while they're living, those who made an impact in the ministry. So it evolved into this. And then the next year, then we said, well, wait a minute, it's Black History Month. Let's wear African garb and really make it a festive event. That really kind of blew it up. Everybody loved it. Go out there and get a good African attire and come out here and we have a good time and we're critiquing one another's clothes and having a behind the scenes contest who did it best. It has evolved into something really special.
Sure, I had the privilege and pleasure of being a speaker at home.
Yes, sir, you tore it up.
God bless you. Had a great time. And I also know that one of the personal highlights, I know that you give out awards, correct? Can you explain what are the names of the awards?
Well, for the brothers, it's called the Preacher Man Award.
Gotcha.
And we have the sound system. We got a song from Rance Allen, and he sings. And we make it real festive. No one knows who's getting the award.
Gotcha.
So it's kind of a surprise. And the women get a Christian Lady Award.
Gotcha.
And,
gotcha.
Tommy Ellison. Late Tommy Ellison sings a song, quartet, I'm a quartet to my heart, so I had to get my quartet guys in there.
Of course.
And we sing those songs, and they play on the sound system, and we just have a good time after the preachment.
Sure.
If we can hold ourselves together after you preach, we were kind of...
Oh, cut it out, man.
In the spirit.
Cut it out. Well, I'm honored and humbled. And I've heard great speakers there. I've seen people. I've received it. I know Antoine received one as well. So what has been, I know I told you how I felt about receiving an award. What are some of the testimonies that people, the family members or recipients of the Preacher Man Award or the Christian Lady Award, I got family members, my wife, my mother, they won, they're real recipients. What are some things that people have said to you, if any?
I think initially they're shocked. We've seen some people that, and the expressions and when their name is called has been a joy to witness. And just people have been very appreciative. You know, everybody wants to be recognized and acknowledged. And oftentimes we are just doing the work of kingdom and we never really pause to thank people for what they've done in ministry. So that has been a joy to seeing some of the people that behind the scenes that have been the backbone and the back that's really held the ministry together, and to be able to tell them thank you in a major way with a lot of people.
Sure.
Once we tell the family members that they're getting an award, the family comes in big numbers. So sure. It's a good for the family to witness
sure.
and to be a part of them getting their flowers and be honored in a way where God is honored as well.
Sure. I'm excited.
I'm
I know
excited.
The speaker this year is going to rip the roof. It's Pastor McCray, for those of you who
yes,
don't
sir.
Know.
Yes, sir.
Any particular theme? I know you can't give the sermon with any particular theme for this year.
I've been asking the Lord as to what I should share, but we are in a series right now entitled The Gospel According to Mary J.
Mary J.
Mary J. Blige. And God is speaking through the song titles sure. of Mary J. And God's been dealing with me with that. I planned it about a year ago, trying to think about what I wanted to do with that, and I think I'm going to do that. There'll be a crowd that'll probably be receptive to it.
Sure.
And I'm excited about it.
I'm excited too.
I'm ready to preach it.
Sure. And for those of you out there who's wondering, the Apostle Paul, he quoted from the poets of his day, so there's a precedent for this.
Yes, sir.
So, Rev, any parting words you want to say to the viewers out there, or just like a last-minute appeal? If
calling all Little Rock Baptist Church ex-members, current members, have any affiliation with the church, have family of the church, go get your African God. Meet me here for Sunday in this month. We're going to have a wonderful time home. Coming celebration again. We got food, we got fun, we got people getting honored. The preach word, let's just come together and have a good time in the name of the Lord. And I'm preaching the gospel according to Mary J. You gotta be here to see this, you gotta hear it. Come share it. My bro's gonna be here, Train's gonna be here, everybody's gonna be here. Come back home, homecoming 2020. Let's get it,
Pastor Mo. Thank you so much. You heard it from the man. All I can say is see you there. God bless you. Keep it real. Pastor McCray.